Exclusive
213. What's up? Welcome back. What is going on with it, everybody? I hope y'all having a good time. So if you can tell right now, there's music playing in the background. This video from the start is going to be getting copyrighted, which means I won't make a dime on this video. So with that, can you please smash the thumbs up button, because it's going to help out the video so people can see it, who got third gens, who are trying to wire their system up. In this video, I 100% intended to play copyrighted music, so I already knew from the bat it's not going to get monetized. So y'all are going to be hearing music throughout the background all day while I'm filming this. So thumbs up for that if you like that nice change up, instead of just hearing random artists or random songs that you've never heard of before. So what we're doing today, y'all, we are wiring up a 4-channel amp for my portal or for my door speakers, and we're wiring up a monoblock amp for my sub. I went ahead, and I'll show y'all right now, picked up 2 10-inch Orion XTRs subs, 500 watt RMS per, with the box on Marketplace. So we got these bad Larrys right here, excellent condition. Kind of bad news, I thought the box would be skinny enough to fit behind the back seat, but it is just a little too fat up here. If it stayed like that, we would be good, but it gets wider and it gets up. So, but what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna just have these chilling on the back seat until I get my 10-inch sub box in. I'll just go online and order one this week sometime. So we're gonna have it chilling on the seat right here and all that good stuff. All right, I took the door panels off because originally I was gonna rerun brand new wire to each door speaker, but instead of doing that, because that is a lot of work, I'm gonna be using the original wiring in here, which I'm going to be showing you guys how to wire. You can actually see my amp down there, I'm place fitting right now, how to wire a 4-channel amp to your speakers. Okay, it is very, very simple, but let me come over here and show y'all what we're working with. Okay, like I said, we're gonna have music in the video, so it is what it is. Turn that down. All right, we good. All right, so check it out. First amp I'm rocking is an Alpine PDX F4. This is going to be a 4-channel amp. It's already in the truck. This is going to be a 4-channel amp. It's 100 watt RMS per channel. So this is a true 400 watt RMS. If you're not too big into sound stuff, 100 watt RMS to one channel, so one speaker, is a lot. Like, you can have some really good sounding music. Your average door speakers in a stock vehicle, they're pumping out anywhere between 8-10 watts to a speaker. You can make some good sound with this. So this is gonna be a 4-channel for our door speaker amp. And then here, I'm testing out a new company I've never messed with before, but it has really good reviews, called DS18. We have a 1,000 watt RMS. So this is a 1,000 watt RMS. So when you look at amps, they got amps out there that say 2,000 watts, 4,000 watts. That doesn't really matter. What matters is the RMS. That's going to be the true power it's applying to whatever speaker system you're working with. Now, me explaining how to choose the right amp for the right speakers, that's a whole another video that you're going to have to Google that, because that just takes too long to explain for this video. So this is going to be powering those 2 10-inch Orion subs. Again, like I said, this is true 1,000 watt RMS. So each sub, because it's a monoblock, each sub will be receiving 500 watt RMS, which is like what it's made for. So we got this set up. You guys already saw the subs, my door speakers. Now, later on in the video, I'm explaining why I have my door speaker boxes out, because there's some information on there that we need when it's time to tune the amp in terms of frequency, so that way we don't blow these speakers, door speakers up. But long time ago, I installed these JBL component or coaxial speakers. They work good, they sound good, there ain't nothing wrong with them. But I'm definitely, we're gonna test these out. So my plan is, if these sound good the way they are wired to the 4-channel, I'm gonna leave it. If I don't like it, I'll upgrade to components, which I have a separate. Long story short, coaxials have the woofer and tweeter combined. Components are gonna be separated. So you're gonna have your woofer or your mid-range, and then they'll have a separate tweeter you can put somewhere. And I also do have dash speakers, but they will be wired up to the fronts. Okay, so here I have a little picture showing how to wire this, because it can get a little crazy. Okay, so right here I'm trying to see if I have my screwdriver. Oh, actually I got a pen, perfect. So right here is my head unit. Okay, so this is my radio. For the 4-channel amp, it's very simple, okay? You're going to run two sets of RCAs, going to be for front and rears, to your 4-channel amp. And then from after that, you're going to run the 4 individual positive and negative wires for each one of your door speakers. You're going to run that from the head unit to the amp, okay? Now, here we got left, right, that's all my speakers, okay? For the sub, very similar, except the speaker wire part. So from the head unit, you're going to run RCA cables and an amp turn-on wire from the head unit to the monoblock amp. And then from the monoblock amp, you're going to run your speaker wires straight to your subs. You're going to obviously have a power that goes from the amp to the battery with a fuse in line. And you're going to have a ground wherever you choose to ground it at. Same thing. You're going to have a positive that runs to the battery. And you're going to have a ground wherever you want to ground it at. Okay. Aftermarket head units come with a blue wire. The blue wire is an amp turn-on wire. You can daisy chain them. So if you got multiple amps, you can twist them together and run it to the single string behind the head unit. It'll turn on all the amps. That blue wire is the key on for your amps, okay? But that's this is a simplified version of this. Now, I'm being a little fancy and a little bougie with it. So what I did was I separated all of my speaker wires. And on top of that, I went to Walmart and bought a label maker. And I labeled each one so it's easily notifiable. Because what's going to happen is... So this is an aftermarket head unit. Don't freak out with all these wires. Aftermarket head unit plugs into your original radio harness and behind your dash, okay? That's what this is. This is my aftermarket plug-in, okay? From there, I'm going to separate and find the individual wires for each speaker, like I already did. What's going to happen here is I'm going to probably come up here somewhere, like right here where my thumb is, and I'm going to cut these. In this case, it'll be 2, 4, 6, 8. It'll be 8 wires. So I'm going to cut these 8 individual wires, and I'm going to splice them, and I'm going to grab my roll of speaker wire, and I'm going to run my speaker wire from the back here of these wires. I'm going to solder them in, and I'm going to run it behind the dash, underneath the carpet, down to my 4-channel amp. My 4-channel amp is going to mount here. Dodge kind of pissed me off with this, because the only way to get the passenger seat off is if you got a... There's a stupid plate that goes underneath, and I remember now when I installed this center console, but there's a stupid plate where... Basically, I would have to remove all this center console, which I don't feel like doing, in order to get this seat to roll back. But the amp will be sitting there. It's going to sit there nicely. Now, in terms of running my power cable, so I'm going to have a fat red, or in this case, green, a fat power wire that's going to be going through here, that hole there. I found that hole, drilled it out with that black stuff around there. It's electrical liquid tape. That way, it's not a sharp. I don't have grommets, but that's going to keep it from not being able to cut through the wire. You can see I did it on this side, too. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna run my power from there up to here. We have new battery terminals that I'm gonna be changing out. A lot of stuff going on, you guys. So this is just, I started already, and I wanted to kind of like get a little head traction, a little traction weight before getting into it, explaining it, all that crazy stuff, trying to get y'all to understand what is going on exactly, okay? So now that I'm at a point where I'm about to start running wires, I want it to stop and be like, break out the camera, okay? A lot of people out there, third-gen Rams, this applies to a 1500, 2500, 3500 Ram. If you got a 2003 to 2009 Dodge Ram, this setup, what I'm going to do, will, and the way I'm doing it, will 100% apply to you. So once again, smash the thumbs up button. This video is not going to make any money. I got music in the background. I got Pandora up going, so... It is what it is. And then once all this installed, obviously I'm going to let y'all hear it with some real music, not no... copyright safe music, you know what I'm saying? That's not how we do it here. So, all right, you guys, I got to get back, get the wiring. I got a lot of stuff to do. I'm going to keep y'all updated, okay? All right, y'all, we got a progress update. So, all my wires are ran for my 4-channel amp. Super clean, you can see here. We got all the wires. I ran it through the dash, and I came down behind the air vent leading here. Very nice, clean, professional bundle. It's not in the way of anything. I zip-tied it. We come down here, you can see I found a little wire harness back there. I use that wire harness just to you know, keep it propped up. The carpet will lay under it, and then it runs all the way down here, and it goes underneath, and then it's sweet because, oh, my flashlight's dead. Let me get my phone light real quick. It's cool because Dodge wanted you to put an aftermarket amp in here because, right, let me slide my amp forward, right there. Is a little pocket that comes out. Now, it's not going to be this long. All this wire is not going to be showing, but came out that little pocket right there. I just ran all the wires through there. The amp connections are back there, and it's going to work out perfectly. Now, the reason why I stopped was because these little guys, first time using them, they're called banana clips. Pretty nifty. So long story short, I'm going to show you guys how to use this. But all my wires are ran, so I did have to go to Walmart and pick up an extra set of RCAs, because for your four-channel amp, for the front and rears require two separate RCA connections. So you can see I already plugged them up in the radio. I want to say the bottom set is for the front and the top set's for the rear speakers. So I just ran them down here. I have a lot of RCA cable left over, so I'm going to pull some slack through and it'll just be underneath the carpet. It'll look clean. Right now you can see, if you're looking, I got all my little tabs on there. So I got left front, we got left, my camera focus, left rear, this one I think is right rear. So everything's labeled, so at any event in the future, if I ever sell the truck, someone's trying to figure out this radio, they're not going to be left with a rat nest of stuff, even though it looks like it right now. It's going to be very clean, very easy to understand. Anybody who understands sound systems will know how this works. Not saying that I have intentions to sell the truck, I'm just saying in the event, or if I want to, down the road, 2 years, 3 years from now, I forgot what wires are what, I can easily reference using the little label maker. So it comes in pretty clutch. So I'm going to show y'all how to set up this banana clip. All right, so for the banana clip, just go ahead and unscrew it all the way like this. Obviously, the little black tab is going to be a negative wire. Take your wire like this, feed it through, and you have the threaded portion, threads, and then above that, the smooth portion. You want to get enough wire to where you can bend it over that smooth portion. If it gets a little bit on the threads, it's not a big deal. Just like that. And then you come over with the top and screw it down. Boom. Snug her down. Banana clip is on. If I tug on it, I'm not going to pull on it hard, but it's very secure. Okay? So, this is something new I've tried. I've never used these before. I saw it on Amazon when I was ordering my speaker wire. So, now what I would do, Alpine provides these removable quick clips, whatever they want to call them. So, I'm going to put this in my negative one. And then I'm going to just come here with a super small Allen key on the side and just tighten her down. Okay, just like that. She's secure. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna plug these into the amp back there. Connect this blue wire is an amp wire, signal wire to turn the amp on. We got the ground here. You can't see it, it's crazy. Got a ground, and then I'm gonna cut my positive. It's too long, so I'm gonna cut it to where I need it to, and then I'm gonna do the same thing like this, okay? All right, y'all, what's up? So we back, it's 2 days later. Long story short, the first day I was filming it, which was the clip y'all just saw, it started raining on me, it got rained on, and it was getting dark. Yesterday I worked, so I didn't have time when I got home to finish it. Today I got home a little early, so I'm trying to wrap this up today, all right? You hear the doors chiming is because I got the key and accessory. I'm gonna play, I have all of the four channel amp wired up. All the door speakers are working except this back one I gotta fuck with a little bit. But I'm gonna play some music for y'all so y'all can hear what it sounds like right now before we put the subs on it, okay? So I got some Tory Lanez on, and then let me turn it down. I'm sorry for the chime. So this is about, I don't know, 15 feet away. Yeah, about 15 to 20 feet away. It's definitely loud. And all four doors are open too, so. Y'all, So that was just the, and I still got fine tuning to do. I'm still trying to tune and dial in the amp and the speakers. I'm pretty sure this harness on this door here, it's common on these third gens for the harness to start acting up. So what's happening is music is not playing from this speaker. I'm just gonna run brand new wire from this speaker to the amp, the four channel. It'll be good as new. I can mess with this stuff later on when I care enough to. I just want to get it wrapped up because now it's like a 2-day job or 3-day job technically, because I wasn't able to work on it yesterday, and you know, I need my truck, so I've been whipping an Impala around. So now what we're gonna do is, and I already started this last video, but I'm gonna wire up the subs now. So real quick, you guys, for the subs, very simple. My amp's gonna be going down here. You can see I pre-ran my wires. If you see here where my hand is, I have my, this green wire is the power. RCA's is the silver. The brownish looking one is the amp turn on wire. Same thing I did on the other side. Lifted up the carpet, ran the wires, not those wires back there, but the power wires there. I went underneath, ran the RCA's down, up, coming out here behind the radio. And then all I'm gonna do for the back, so I'm ordering a sub box for the back cab tomorrow. And in the meantime, this is gonna be hooked up sitting right here. And all I have to do is from the amp here, that's gonna be the amp, by the way, the monoblock. That amp is going to just have two speaker wires. That's it, just two wires running along here. And it's gonna lead to, it's gonna look super clean. It's gonna be to the back of the mega cab. So that's what we're doing. That's what I'm gonna do. But yeah. So right now, I'm gonna finish up the wiring for the subs. Once I finish that, I'll get back with y'all and show y'all what I'm exactly doing. All right, you guys, what's going on? Last day. You guys, it's been kind of crazy. So sound system is done. It's like 95% done. I just have like a few small things I gotta touch up on that I will talk about in right now here in a little bit. Long story short, last clip y'all saw, that was 2 days ago. I was rushing and trying to get the system done because I needed to take my truck to work yesterday. Well, it was Wednesday. So what happened was, got everything done, subs work, sounds good. Everything's back together, buttoned up. And took the truck up the street to get some food, came back. As soon as I got in the driveway, my water pump took a dump. Water pump took a poop. So what happened is the water pump took a, it shit itself so bad that it freaking shredded my belt. So my belt popped, and then when the belt popped, it messed up the crankshaft sensor down at the bottom. If you know what a crankshaft sensor is and where it's at on these trucks, you know what I'm talking about. It's cold, I'm not getting on the ground right now. Messed up the crank sensor. Actually, I got the belt right here. I'll show you guys here. Yeah, that is the remains of my serpentine belt right there. Okay, so truck's down in terms of driving it, but we have electricity, which means we can power some subs real quick. But I just figured I'd show y'all down there. The old water pump, it's yeah, she's messed up. But real quick, you guys, so first things first, the wiring. So for my powers, this one's for the subs, and actually this one's green, one's for the sub, black one's for the whatchamacallit, the four channel amp. Okay, I got these circuit breaker switches incorporated. So for the four channel, I got an 80 amp, and then for the subs, I have a 120 amp. What's nice about these is if I want to kill power, like if I'm going to park the truck for a long time and I want to kill power, all you got to do is hit that button and it kills power to the amp. So that way you don't have to worry about parasitic draw killing your batteries. It's nice if you're going to park your vehicle for a long time without having to disconnect stuff. So if I want to reset it, or if the amp pop, or if the circuit breaker pops, it kills power. So I like these because we've all popped at least a fuse once with sound systems. So instead of having to worry about having a new fuse on hand, swapping it out, if it pops, all I gotta do is push it in, it's reset. Okay, so we got that. I gotta finish cleaning up the wire, so you can see my power, that green power wire right there. I got it running behind that fire guard coming out there, and then it goes inside the cab. All right, so we're inside the truck, everything is buttoned back up. Subs are sitting right there on the chair until my 10-inch box comes in. So what I'm gonna do now, you guys, is I'm going to go ahead and give you a sound demo of the system. My camera's running low, so it's not gonna be super long, but I will play a couple songs for y'all.
Go ahead, hit agree.
And we're using Bluetooth right now. Okay. So, let's see. Here we go. First song is going to be Baby. It got Lil Baby and the Baby featured in it. So, let me know what y'all think.
Out there, I don't discriminate. We got the good stuff.
When the sun goes down on my side of town, that lonesome feeling comes to my door. The whole world climbs.
So that is it in terms of the sound. Now obviously keep in mind this is a camera, so your sound's not gonna 100% transfer, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's not gonna sound the way it sounds on the camera is not 100% what it sounds like in person. I was just trying to get you guys, you know, a sound clip of it. Now, you guys, again, remember, this video is not making any money, so please smash the thumbs up. It helps out so much because I'm not getting monetized for it, okay? But yeah, it sounds good. The speakers right now, and I'm gonna be 100% honest with you, the subs right now, they are not hitting as hard as they was when I had the truck running. I got a feeling because my batteries are at 12 volts right now, or they're probably a little lower than that because I tried cranking the truck a few times. But long story short, it's not, the amps aren't getting the full juice right now, I'm pretty positive. So
those subs are not actually hitting as hard as they can. Again, you guys, this is a budget sound system. This is not a professional, like, you know, $5,000 setup with, you know, 2,000 watt subs. It's not that. This is just a thing to be able, if you want beat, if you want bass in your truck, clean bass. You know, I've had my days with the 15s, the 12s. I've tried them all, man. I've went through a lot of stuff. But for me and what I want in my truck, you know, keep in mind I got a family and whatnot. I just want this to be able to be, you know, banging and stuff, if that makes any sense. And it hits. It sounds really good. Like when I drove it, the one time before the water pump died, when I drove it, it freaking sounded really good. Now a couple issues. Number one, not getting any sound out of the back passenger driver's side door. That speaker's not working. And then for some reason, back driver door and then my front passenger door is not having any sound come out of it. Another thing too is these are component door speakers, or not component, coaxial door speakers. They are a two-in-one. It has a mid or a woofer, and it has a tweeter incorporated into it. I do not plan to keep these door speakers and dash speakers in here for long, because in all honesty, I actually want a little bit more. I want a lot more clarity. These speakers can only do so much, handle so much at a certain hertz and wattage. I want more clarity in my music, and I want my music to be louder. So for this head unit, volume 30 is like the max I will take it to before it starts to distort the speakers and starts clipping and stuff. I know for a fact if I had a good component set of speakers, it would sound so good, because that Alpine amp, that sucker can power 100 watts per channel, so each door can receive 100 watt RMS, which is really, really good. So that amp's not even working a quarter of what its potential is. So we're definitely going to be back making sound content. If you guys want to drop down below anything you recommend in terms of brands, I'm big into, I like the Roxford Fosgates. JL's kind of is good, but it's out of price range. Roxford Fosgates, there's a brand called NVX that's good. DS18, that DS18's monoblock sub is really good. I like it because it has a clipping light on there, so if it starts to clip, it'll flash a little bit. There's another brand. There's some brands out there. I've tried a lot of brands, but anyways, I want y'all to still comment. Let me know what you think. Comment what you think about the whole video, about the setup. You know, did you like the way I put the amps underneath the driver and passenger seat, and they had a little cutout right there so we can run the wires? I mean, it looks really, really clean, you guys. This is not no ghetto janky looking stuff, you know. I mean, I got a zip tie this side. I got to zip tie those together. That's not a part of it. That's just a wire for my phone. But I got to zip tie these suckers together, just to clean it up a little bit. Shit, I'll show y'all right here. You know what I'm saying? Just to kind of tidy that up. I mean, you can't see it though from like outside, or if I come back here, you don't see nothing. All you see is an RCA cable. I could have slid that amp up a little bit more. I probably will, because that way no one kicks it and breaks it. This side looks super clean too. Passenger side, everything's all buttoned up. All the door panels came back on. I mean, you guys, I got to clean up. I haven't even had time to clean up, you guys, but everything looks really clean. I have wires coming all in here, but you really couldn't be able to tell unless I just told you. Amp comes here, same thing. I got to zip tie this side up, get her all buttoned up, but it looks really clean. I got some wire cover. I might break out and just cover it up a little bit, but hopefully you guys, this video, I know it was all over the place towards the end, hopefully this video, you guys, helped y'all out a lot. Now you guys know what's going to be coming next on the content. So we will be changing the water pump. So I've changed it before on here back in 18. If you don't know how to change a water pump, well, you're going to learn when I change mine. Very simple. And we're going to be replacing the serpentine belt because I don't have one. And we're going to change the crankshaft sensor, which is super simple. It takes like 10 minutes to take. It's just the Allen screw and you unplug it. So we should be back on the road, hopefully early next week. Sub box is ordered. I don't know when it's going to get here, but eventually those subs will be in the back, behind the back of the cab, which is going to look really clean. But yeah. I mean, this is, yeah, I got to clean up the truck. It's messy. It is messy for sure. But those Orion XTRs 10s, they actually hit really good, you guys. Again, I apologize for not being able to have a lot of bass, or, you know what I'm saying? Like, I don't know if you was expecting like that window rattling, watching the hood, the roof flex. Like, I'm past those days, man. I've enjoyed that stuff. Who knows, maybe I'll get freaky with the Impala out there, because I have stuff planned and lined up for it. But yeah, So until next time, you guys, if there's anything I didn't mention, comment, let me know. Again, that battery cable terminal setup over there, that is not final. It's going to change because I have some aftermarket, very, very nice terminals. I'm not going to show y'all, but I have some that it's going to look clean. It's going to look really clean. Shout out to Sub-Zero. But yeah, so y'all take care. Peace out. Smash the thumbs up button on your way out. It takes 2 seconds. It's free. Thank you guys so much for checking out the channel. Let me know what y'all think. And until next time, you guys take care. Be safe and peace out.